Oh, excuse me. I was just enhancing my brain through meditation. Greetings, my fellow level 5 laser lotuses. Julian here for DNews, and I have some info for you to reflect upon. A research team from the University of Singapore announced this week that they have observed actual quantitative and qualitative physiological effects of meditation. Moreover, the effects are radically different depending on how meditation is practiced. Maria Kuzhevnikov and Dr. Amahai studied 4 groups of practiced meditationers from Thailand and Nepal. 2 groups practiced meditation from the Theravada schools of Buddhism, and the other 2 were experienced in Vajrayana meditations. The researchers monitored electrocardiograph, that's your heart, and electric encephalograph, that's your brain, responses, and also gave these groups cognitive tasks. What they discovered was the Theravada meditation had a calming effect, which makes sense. Theravada is the oldest surviving form of Buddhism. It literally translates to the teaching of the elders, and its meditations focus on tranquility and abstract understanding to be free of suffering and stress. It's no coincidence then that the EKGs showed an increase in high frequency activity in the heart when the subjects were meditating compared to when they were at rest. More high frequency activity is associated with the activation of the parasympathetic nervous system, which calms us and stimulates digestion and sexual arousal. On the other hand, practitioners of the Vajrayana school saw a decrease in the high frequency component of their heart rate variability when they were meditating, meaning they had activated the sympathetic nervous system. The sympathetic nervous system is complementary to the parasympathetic. It stimulates the fight or flight response by stimulating the release of hormones like norepinephrine and epinephrine, better known as adrenaline. This challenges the previous notion that meditation could only be used for relaxation. Even better, the Vajrayana subjects performed better on the cognitive tasks, and not just a little better. The effect was instant and dramatic after just 1 session. Theravada, meanwhile, didn't improve the performance on the same tasks. The researchers note that Vajrayana takes years of practice and plan to study if just using some basic elements from it can have the same effect. So this means if you need to psych yourself up to do well on a test or a job interview, maybe you should meditate. And when you need to calm down after, a different kind of meditation can bring you back down again. There are even more benefits of meditation. Check out Lacey breaking it down for you here. And maybe it'll help you heal now that she's no longer on the team. I know, I miss her too. And do you meditate? What have you noticed from your own experiences? Let us know in the comments. Until then, let's keep chasing enlightenment through science, and I'll see you next time on DNews.